Hi everyone, welcome to my channel DigiPrits. Today's video is going to be a game changer for all those young professionals out there, especially those that are starting out their career with entry level salaries. We're diving into the world of budgeting and showing you exactly how you can make your money work for you and not the other way around. We all know that the first paycheck can feel like a major milestone. I remember that the first salary that I received was when I was going out with my dad, and my dad said, "Why don't you buy us breakfast?" And we had like a plate of idli chutney sambar. I know it's the most unfanciest thing, but that's exactly what we did with my first salary. Like something that I got for my dad out of the money that I earned all by myself from my first job. So it was a huge moment for me. Keeping that aside, I know budgeting cannot sound so easy for anyone. I don't even recollect if I had any savings for the first few years of my life. I don't even know where it's all gone. Probably in EMIs. But yeah, I've started saving only like a couple of years back, and I've been doing significantly well. So that's why I'm here to break it down and make it simple for all of you. So what exactly is budgeting in this particular context, right? It simply means creating a plan for how you will save and spend money every month. Let me break down the steps for you. Step one, track your income. Figure out exactly how much money you're going to be bringing in after taxes, provident fund, professional tax, any insurance premium, etc., whatever you opted in for. What is that exact amount that gets credited to your account at the end of every month? Step two, categorize your expenses. Make different categories of your spending types, like it could be rent or house EMI, it could be groceries, transportation, entertainment, and the categories can vary from person to person. So depending upon the type of expenses that you make, make like broad buckets of categories that you can start off with. Step three, set spending limits. Understand how much you can realistically afford to spend in each of these categories. You can't be like, okay, I make 20,000 a month and my rent is 18,000. This kind of a format is not going to work out. So either you have to find a job that gives you a better income or find a place which has a lower rent. So figure out how much you can actually realistically afford to spend in each of these categories and set a target. Like, this is how much I can spend. Like 2,000 is how much I'm going to spend on my entertainment, for example, and stick to it. Step four, prioritize savings. Allocate a certain portion of your salary towards your savings, because you'll never know what you'll need it for. You might need it for an emergency fund, travel, or future investments. Emergencies could be like maybe your bike got repaired, your car got repaired, heater is under repair, your washing machine is broken and you need to buy a new one. It could be anything and you need funds for it. Sometimes it could be really, really expensive. So you need to set aside money for all of those things. For example, your friend is getting married or your cousin is getting married and you need to go there, etc. So on and so forth. It could be anything. There could be numerous number of reasons for which you might have to spend money. So it's always good to set aside some amount in your savings. Okay, now that we have the basic set, let's do like an example or budgeting with a sample salary of 10 lakh CTC. Now, before we jump into the nitty gritty, let's talk about a popular budgeting rule that you might have heard of, which is the 50-30-20 rule. It's a great starting point for beginners. 50% for your needs. This includes all your essential expenses like rent, housing, groceries, utilities, transportation, and loan repayments, if any, which most of us do right now. 30% for your wants. This is like your fun money, which could cover you dining out, like your entertainment, your movies, your travel, your shopping, everything that you can do for what you're living for. And then 20% goes into your savings, which is again your emergency fund for your future financial security, your investments, and other saving needs. Savings are super, super important, because the current era that we live in, we all don't know if we can sustain our job. And if in case, God forbid, you do get laid off and there are a couple of months where you have expenses and EMIs, and if you don't have those savings, you will be in a huge financial burden and you don't want to be in that sort of a space. Now, let's get specific. For a CTC of INR 10 lakhs per annum in India, your take home after salary could be around like range from 65,000 to 75,000 per month. And here's how you can apply the 50-30-20 rule. So needs will be 50%, which is allocating around 32,500 to 37,500 for all of your essential expenses that you cannot live without, which is your rent, groceries, utilities, bills, etc. You can keep aside so much for your needs. The second bucket is the wants, which is 30% of it. Set aside 19,500 to 22,500 for all of your entertainment, dining out, shopping, and all of those experiences. It can vary. Some people might be having these expenses a little larger because they're like YOLO, you live only once, and they keep that category a little higher. Completely up to you, but this is for a starting salary. It'll help you understand where you need to spend and where you need to save. The third category is, of course, savings, which is 20%. So, like, keep aside like 13,000 to 15,000 every month for your savings. Like, it could be your emergency fund or any of those other elements. Budgeting doesn't mean you have to sacrifice all the fun in life. It just means you have to be smart about the type of choices that you make based on your financial goals. So, you could have like budget friendly options for a lot of things that you want to do. Go for like a hike or a picnic, or if you want to eat out at restaurants, look at better options or like budget friendly options. Or you can also try cooking at home for a change with your friends and all of those other elements. Now I've got some extra tips on how you can make the most out of your budget. The first thing being track your expenses. You can use an app or you can use a simple spreadsheet for every rupee that you spend. I know this can sound like a cumbersome task, but it can be easy with a lot more apps that are out there. I track all my expenses and I also have like a spending limit that I put for each of those categories. So whenever, let's say, I have kept aside 2000 for entertainment category, and if I've spent 50% of that category, it will show me that, and I will know that for the rest of the month I have only 50% of my entertainment money left. So I am very conscious when I'm spending that money as well, because in the current era that we live in, I think I'm saying this again, because of UPIs, it has become so easy for us to just spend like scan, pay, that we just don't understand where the money is going. So it's important for us to categorize and keep track of where our money is going. Otherwise, it's just going to flow like water right out of your bank account. And before you can even think and look back upon, there'll be nothing over there. Next one is to check on your subscriptions. Like, it could be your gym subscription. Are you really going to the gym every single time that you have spent it for? Other like premium subscriptions for your like Netflix, etc., and all of those. See if you can do like a family plan and share it with other people. It just becomes a lot more cost effective. Or with your friends, if you want to share between both of you, because I don't think you would be streaming the same movie at the same time. So maybe you can share and cut back on those expenses a little bit, especially because if you're like starting out and it's your first job and you want to save, I think these are some of the things that you can look out. The last one that I want to tell you is to set financial goals. When you have a target that, okay, this is how much I want to save at the end of the year, it really motivates you to work towards that goal. Like every month, I think it's always good to have two bank accounts for sure, so that your money is not all stuck in one bank account. So every time you get your salary, move out that 20% savings into that other bank account and see if you don't have like UPI set to it, so that it becomes a little bit difficult to spend that money out directly. By having these goals set in mind, you can work towards also some of the things that you want to do in the future, like buying a house, buying a car, buying that scooty or buying that iPhone that you want. You can all work towards those expenses or goals that you have in your mind that you want, all by putting in some savings every month, so that you don't have to have a huge hole in your pocket the moment you have a massive expense in front of you. Remember this one thing: budgeting is a journey. It's not something that you'll get right directly. Like, oh yeah, I've set a target and I'm going to stick to it. There are going to be so many times that you're going to slip out of your targets completely over and above the expenses that you might have, like 100% more than how much target that you kept for that particular category. And it's completely okay. We all make mistakes. It's completely fine. It will take a lot of trial and error to understand what fits well for your financial goals. So figure that out and it will eventually flow in. I know I've not discussed about investments yet, but if you want to save taxes, you should definitely look at investing some of your money as well. It could be into your future savings. That could be for another video altogether. But if this video was helpful, give this video a big thumbs up and share it with your friends as well, maybe. your future self is going to be thanking you so much for budgeting right now, because you're going to save so much for your future. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and see you all next time.